Step 2 Christ, Chapter 3, Repentance. Pages 35 and 36. Many accept an intellectual religion, a form of godliness, when the heart is not cleansed. Let it be your prayer, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Psalm 51 verse 10. Deal truly with your own soul. Be as earnest, as persistent, as you would be if your mortal life were at stake. This is a matter to be settled between God and your own soul, settled for eternity. A supposed hope and nothing more will prove your ruin. Study God's word prayerfully. That word presents before you, in the law of God and the life of Christ, the great principles of holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Hebrews 12 verse 14. It convinces of sin. It plainly reveals the way of salvation. Give heed to it as the voice of God speaking to your soul. As you see the enormity of sin, as you see yourself as you really are, do not give up to despair. It was sinners that Christ came to save. We have not to reconcile God to us, but a wondrous love. God in Christ is reconciling the world unto Him. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 19. He is wooing by His tender love the hearts of His erring children. No earthly parent could be as patient with the faults and mistakes of his children as is God with those He seeks to save. No one could plead more tenderly with the transgressor. No human lips ever poured out more tender entreaties to the wanderer than does He. All His promises, His warnings, are but the breathing of unutterable love. When Satan comes to tell you that you are a great sinner, look up to your Redeemer and talk of His merits. That which will help you is to look to His light. Acknowledge your sin, but tell the enemy that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners and that you may be saved by His matchless love. 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 15. Jesus asked Simon a question in regard to two debtors. One owed his Lord a small sum, and the other owed him a very large sum. But he forgave them both, and Christ asked Simon which debtor would love his Lord most. Simon answered, "He to whom you forgave most." Luke 7 verse 43. We have been great sinners, but Christ died that we might be forgiven. The merits of His sacrifice are sufficient to present to the Father in our behalf. Those to whom He has forgiven most will love Him most and will stand nearest to His throne to praise Him for His great love and infinite sacrifice. It is when we most fully comprehend the love of God that we best realize the sinfulness of sin. When we see the length of the chain that was laid down for us, when we understand something of the infinite sacrifice that Christ has made in our behalf, the heart is melted with tenderness and contrition. Step to Christ, pages 35 and 36, July 17.